What's going on, you guys? Welcome back to another video and to the channel. So for this video, I'm going to be doing my very first oil change on my F80 M3. So I've put almost 4,000 miles on this car since I first bought it 9 months ago, back in November last year. And the previous owner said the last oil change he did was in March of last year. So I estimate the last oil change was done about 5,000 miles ago. And as I've mentioned before, I do oil changes on my BMWs every 5,000 miles. So with that being said, let's get started on this oil change. So this is the oil change kit I'm going to be using to do this. I got this kit from fcpero.com, which is where I get most of my maintenance items. On the website, it says this kit is specifically for the S55 engine. As you guys can see, it comes with 7 liters of SAE 0W30 engine oil. It also comes with a new oil filter and then new oil filter gaskets and a new crusher washer for the drain plug. So it comes with everything you need to do the oil change on this car. Now, this kit was $128, so it was double what I usually pay for my oil change kits from fcpero.com. For those of you who've been watching the channel for a while, you may have noticed that this oil change kit is different from what I usually get for my E90 and what I used to get for my F30. I usually get the Liqui-Moly 5W30 engine oil change kit from fcpero, but in the owner's manual for this car, it recommends an oil viscosity of 0W30, and this was the only oil change kit with an oil viscosity of 0W30, so that is why I got this one. So this one is genuine BMW, so that's probably why it's more expensive. The Liqui-Moly oil change kit that I usually get is about $65, so this one is pretty much double in price. So the process for doing the oil change should be identical to the N52 engine in my E90 328i, and then also identical to the N55 engine that was in my F30 335i. Since the drain plug is in the same area, the oil filter housing is in the same area. So doing this oil change should be very easy for me since I've done this a bunch of times already. So let's go ahead and get started here by lifting up the car. As you guys can see, I already have the quick check set up so that we can easily, quickly, and safely lift up the car. So the first thing I'm gonna do here before I start draining the oil is loosen the oil filter housing cap right here and then open the fill cap here. That way the oil can drain out of the engine faster once I remove the drain plug. So I'm gonna use this oil filter housing wrench that I got from Amazon to loosen the oil filter housing cap. I'll go ahead and open up the cap here real quick. All right, so now that I have the oil fill cap removed and then the oil filter housing cap loosened, now we can go ahead and start draining the oil. I'm gonna go ahead and use this oil drain catch container to catch the oil that comes out once I remove the drain plug. So the oil drain plug is going to be this bolt right here, and it is a 17 millimeter. So I'm using a 17 millimeter socket here to loosen it. Alright, so while the oil finishes draining, I'm gonna go ahead and remove the oil filter housing cap so that I can change out the oil filter. So now I'm going to go ahead and replace the gaskets that are on the oil filter housing cap here. So you guys can see there's a black one there, a large black one, and then a small green one up here. And as you can see, the kit comes with a new black one and a new green one. I'm gonna use this little pick tool here that I have to get the gaskets out. That gasket went flying, but here's the small green gasket. Here I have the new large gasket. Go ahead and put that on. And then here's the new small green gasket. There we go. Got both of the new gaskets on. Go ahead and oil those up a little bit. Now I'm going to go ahead and put in the new oil filter. There we go. And just like that, this piece is ready to be put back on the engine. For the oil filter cap, you just tighten it down until you can't turn it anymore. At a certain point, it'll just stop turning. Now I'm gonna go ahead and reinstall the drain plug. First, I'm gonna go ahead and remove the old crusher washer. Now I'll go ahead and reinstall the new one that came with the kit. Now I'll go ahead and reinstall the drain plug. Now I'll go ahead and torque down the drain plug to 18 foot-pounds of torque. Now I'm going to go ahead and fill the engine with 6.5 liters of oil. So now that the engine is filled with 6.5 liters of oil, we are pretty much almost done. The last step I need to do is check the oil level. So let's go ahead and get inside the car here. Let's go ahead and turn the iDrive on. Scroll over to my vehicle. Let's go to vehicle status. Let's go down to oil. Go ahead and turn the engine on so we can measure the oil. All right, so I guess I have to go for a drive first before measuring the oil. This wasn't a requirement on my previous BMWs, so this is new to me. I'm not sure why you have to go for a drive first, but I guess I'll do that and then I'll show you guys the results. In the meantime here, I guess I could show you guys how to reset the oil service warning. So with the car in accessory mode, just hold down this button here in the corner. And then you guys can see it gives you the option to reset whatever warning is popping up. So I'll go ahead and press it again, hold it down, and press it again. And there we go. That is how you reset the oil service or any service warning that's popping up on your instrument cluster. Super easy, took less than 30 seconds. So there you guys have it. That is how you do an oil change on the S55, my F80 M3. It really is very easy. It is exactly the same process as it is on a 3 Series. The only difference is that the oil change kit may be a bit more expensive, but that's just what comes with, you know, owning an M car. Maintenance is gonna be more expensive. Also, I was able to check the oil level, and it did end up being at the appropriate level, so we are good there. So yeah, I'll go ahead and link the exact oil change kit that I used on my F80 M3 in this video from FCP Euro. I'll also link some tools that I use to do the oil change that I got from Amazon. And if you guys have any questions or anything about the oil change, feel free to comment down below. But yeah, anyway, I think that's just gonna do it for this video. Thank you guys for joining me in this video. Give the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and subscribe for more content if you liked what you saw. Also, feel free to check out inline6auto.com if you're looking for any aftermarket upgrades for your BMW. I'll have it linked in the description of this video as well. But otherwise, I'll see you guys in the next video.